an exclusive story from Iraq on American citizens, civilians, fighting the Islamic State group. Many are former U.S. military, but some have never seen a battle before. Special correspondent Marcia Biggs reports.
American boots are back on the ground in Iraq. This time they're volunteers, U.S. military veterans on the front lines against the Islamic State. And among them, one woman. 25-year-old Samantha Johnston was a private in the Army for 2 years before she left to be a stay-at-home mom to her three children. When the Islamic State began dominating the news last year, she says she sat in her North Carolina home watching videos of their atrocities and felt compelled to join the fight.
Something inside of me just snapped, and I couldn't allow myself to sit down and do nothing when all of these children here are in trouble, and me and my family are just living happily in America.
She made contact with other volunteers through social media sites, and 3 months ago, she packed her bags and flew to Iraq, where she volunteered with the Kurdish army, the Peshmerga, in the fight against IS. She says she's become close to the Kurdish soldiers in her unit, even listing herself on Facebook by a Kurdish name.
They've become my family, and I plan to stay here for as long as I can, as long as they need me to be here.
She spends her days training for battle, but has not yet seen any combat.
In the cover.
Back in her army days, her job was making maps for deployed units, but she never got the chance to go overseas.
Check.
I really wanted to be deployed, but my unit never deployed.
Is that why you're here?
Probably. Probably one of the many reasons why I'm here.
And she's not the only one. Officials at the U.S. State Department believe that more than 150 Americans have voluntarily traveled to Iraq and Syria to fight in the ongoing conflict.
Here is Galhat Roman. I'm from the Boston area, from Lynn.
Just last month, 36-year-old Keith Broomfield became the first American known to die while fighting IS. He was killed near the Syrian town of Kobani.
Next village is right over there, this ISIS on the back.
Many of the volunteers we met are military veterans, like 29-year-old Jeremy Woodard, who spent years fighting in Iraq and Afghanistan, but struggled back home.
It was hard to get a job. You barely even get a job at McDonald's flipping a burger. You know, they look at you, they see your resume for, you know, serving in the U.S. Army honorably, but they look at you like you're a hazard. You know, you're gonna hurt somebody.
When IS fighters swept through Iraq last summer, Woodard also left family behind, jumping at the chance to get involved in the fight in honor of his fellow soldiers who fought and died in the U.S. war in Iraq.
All those people got killed over here for fighting, you know, for cause. I didn't want them to die in vain.
There's been a lot of intense fighting going on.
Woodard's unit has seen some combat, fighting alongside the Peshmerga. Back in April, they established this defensive line after a fierce battle with IS fighters, a force these volunteers say is one to be reckoned with.
We don't recognize them as terrorists. We actually recognize them as the actual army. They're well-trained, sophisticated, whenever they get into battle as well, very disciplined in that manner.
Despite never serving in the military, Danny was one of the volunteers who was wounded in that battle, shot in the leg.
You ready to die for this?
Am I ready to die for this? Well, I've been out here for the last 7 months already. I pretty much made up my mind to go ahead and help out these people, or help out those people that aren't able to help themselves. So if that'll be a matter of fact to do so, then hey, it is what it is.
The volunteers say they're here out of moral obligation. They're not even being paid. And while it's not technically illegal, the U.S. State Department is adamant that it does not support their participation in this conflict.
But for these Americans, it wasn't even a question.
I'm having a great time out here. I feel more comfortable here than I ever felt in America.
After serving in Iraq, Justin Smith says he suffered from post-traumatic stress disorder. Several attempts at treatment failed, and he finally sold everything he owned to buy a one-way ticket back. He says Iraq seems like paradise compared to the hell of staying in the U.S.
In the States, there's too much idle time. Too much time just doing nothing or sitting around drinking or anything like that. It's better here. Like I said it countless times, I get to do my job. I love my job.
Do you think you can ever go back to the U.S.?
Probably. I mean, I won't like it, but I'll have to go back eventually.
I don't think I could leave for good.
While the Peshmerga does not officially allow foreigners to volunteer, local authorities often look the other way when volunteers arrive, and they've been largely embraced, sometimes simply out of Kurdish hospitality. But one Kurdish officer told us that while he appreciates the volunteers, this is not what they need from the United States.
We don't need exactly people come fight for us. We need weapons. We need equipment, supply from the American government, from the European countries.
We asked Jeremy why he thinks it's his business to fight in a war that the U.S. is not directly waging.
It should be everybody's business. If it doesn't get stopped over here, it's going to keep spreading.
Do you think there's so many ISIS sleeper cells in
I believe it.
The United States?
I think there's quite a few.
Why do you believe that?
I mean, that's a good question. I mean, they keep claiming that they're there. I mean, who knows? It's a possibility that they're not. But honestly, I believe they are.
So why not be in the United States searching out sleeper cells?
I mean, this is where the fight is right now. It's got to get controlled here.
Johnston faces a firestorm of controversy over leaving behind her 5-year-old and her 3-year-old twins to volunteer in a war on the other side of the world, where we're told IS fighters have put a $300,000 price on her head.
I see these refugee children, I see just the normal poor children here, and I think of my children, and my children are happy, they're safe, they're fed, they have more than they need, and they're okay.
You said my kids have everything they need, but they don't have their mom.
They don't. But I will spend the rest of my life making that up to them.
You cried all the way to the airport?
I don't want to think about it. That was the hardest day of my life. I'll never leave them again when I come back. Never. Every day is a battle not to come back. Every day I look up prices to fly back. But I have a goal here, and I can't just give up.
It's a goal and a cause they all believe in, but it's also an escape.
It's an escape. Yeah. It's like a vacation here. It's kind of sick to say. After I graduated, I went straight to the Army. So I was 17 when I went in. I just know war. That's it. I'm still searching. Searching for what? I don't know. Searching for a part of myself, where I belong. I belong in a place like this.
For those still searching, the fight against IS provides yet another war. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Marcia Biggs in northern Iraq.
Since our interview, Samantha Johnston left Iraq for Europe and posted on her Facebook page that although it is, quote, time to start heading back to my family, she indicated that she will be returning to Iraq.